The title of my speech today is it safe to keep an exotic animal as pets? How many of you all have exotic animal as pets?
No. No.
No.
Okay, Harish has one. Okay, what do you all know about exotic animal?
Snakes.
Examples of exotic animal that you all know?
Snakes.
Snakes, spiders, which are read as pets nowadays, monkeys, but these animals has adverse effects to us which we may not know. So one of the effects is public safety at risk. When these animals are caged or chained or read as pet in the house, these animals become more stressful and they become more aggressive. It increases the chances of them attacking an individual. So it is not safe for us to be around with this animal at that point of time. So the second point is when these animals are given lack of attention or not given enough care or not cared properly, these animals take the chance to escape. This escaping of these animals can cause a panic situation in the neighborhood and also can cause a loss of peacefulness in the community. For an example, when we come home to our house and we find a snake in our house, what will be our first reaction? You try to push the snake. We try to push the snake away from the house. By we doing it so, the snake thinks that we are attacking it, and by return for defense, it tries to attack us back, which might end up in a dangerous situation if it is not handled properly or carefully. Then the second point is human health at risk. Since exotic animals are from the wilds, they are known as carriers of zoonotic disease. Zoonotic disease are very dangerous disease. If it is transmitted to human, it can be a very fatal disease if human transmit it. Examples of zoonotic disease are herpes B and salmonellosis. This disease can be transmitted to human when they come in contact with these animals. For example, the owner touches the animal, or even though if someone touches the saliva of the animal, even the mucus that produced from the animal touches anyone, it can be very dangerous. The conditions that this animal causes are very dangerous. In severe cases, there are paralysis of limbs, and also it can also lead to death. Especially when there's children in the house, it is not safe to rear these animals because children have low immunity level, where they can be infected easily by this disease. So, in conclusion, I'd like to say that. In conclusion, I'd like to say that it is not safe to rear these animals, but even though there are people outside who are rearing these animals safely, but the lesser they know that they are getting, they are risking their health towards this disease. So it is better for these animals to be in the wild where they feel comfortable, safe and free compared to be stuck in a cage or chain in someone's house. So thank you.